since the first day as a midshipman. When we march into Bancroft Hall, the largest dormitory in North America, we are struck with the historic nature of that building. As we first march in through these center doors on induction day, the day we leave behind civilian life and begin our transition to being members of the United States Navy, we enter the rotunda, a massive room with beautiful architecture, in the center of which is a staircase leading upward into a sacred place we call Memorial Hall. Even from entering the rotunda, your eyes are drawn up through the center door to the flag which reads, "Don't give up the ship." Memorial Hall is a beautiful room, built similar in time to the Salt Lake Temple. It is similar in architecture to the Celestial Room in the Salt Lake Temple. As you walk into the room, the first thing your eyes are drawn to is a large blue flag with white letters that say, "Don't give up the ship." Below the flag is a plaque which reads, "Dedicated to the honor of those alumni who have been killed in action defending the ideals of their country. With immortal valor and the price of their lives, these prove their love of country and their loyalty to the high traditions of their alma mater by inscribing with their own blood their narrative of their deeds above, on, and underneath the seven seas. They have set the course. They silently stand watch wherever Navy ships fly the waters of the globe." Below the plaque is a list of every Naval Academy midshipman who has given their life in service to our country. Since graduating in 2006, some of my classmates' names have been added to that list. From the class of 2004, the class I was in before my mission, this is Travis Mannion. Born in Doylestown, Pennsylvania, later commissioned in the United States Marine Corps, serving in Marine Ground, he was posthumously awarded a Silver Star. The citation reads in part that his patrol was just finishing a search of a suspected insurgent's house and came under precision small arms at fire attack, with their corpsman grievously wounded by enemy fire and the attack developing into a full-scale ambush. He and a fellow Marine exposed themselves to the increasing fire to pull the corpsman out of the kill zone. After recovering the corpsman and administering first aid, he led his patrol in a counterattack, personally eliminating an enemy position with his M4 carbine and M203 grenade launcher. As he continued to direct the patrol, another Marine was wounded by the enemy's accurate fire. He again moved across the kill zone, under fire by five insurgents, to recover the wounded Marine. Iraqi Army reinforcements, halted by an improvised explosive device, were unable to advance on the flank of the insurgents, and he and his patrol found themselves taking fire from three sides. While fearlessly exposing himself to gain a more advantageous firing position and drawing enemy fire away from the wounded Marines, he was fatally wounded by an enemy sniper. His courageous and deliberate actions inspired the eventual counterattack and ultimately saved the lives of every member of his patrol. This is Brendan Looney. Following graduation, he served as an intel officer for a few years and then became a Navy SEAL. Less than 2 weeks finishing SEAL training and earning his trident, he married Amy Hastings. Right before he finished his final deployment as a SEAL in Afghanistan, only 10 days before coming back to the United States, his helicopter went down in the mountains of Afghanistan. After returning from my mission, I joined the class of 2006. These are classmates of mine who have passed away in service to our nation. First is Brandon Barrett from Marion, Indiana, I had Russian classes with Brandon. He was very kind to me and a good, happy friend. Brandon was killed while conducting combat operations in support of Operation Enduring Freedom in 2010 in Afghanistan. This is Daniel Bartle from Ferndale, Washington. I saw him around. I didn't know him very well, though. He was killed in a helicopter crash in 2012 in Afghanistan. This is Stanford Shaw from Basking Ridge, New Jersey. I knew him fairly well and had a few classes with him in political science. He was among 7 Marines and 4 soldiers killed when their helicopter crashed during a training mission in Florida. And finally, this is Michael Quinn from Percival, Virginia. He was killed in 2012 when 2 helicopters collided while training in Arizona in preparation for deployment to Afghanistan. This is a Memorial Day tribute to these great men. Men that I knew, men that weren't perfect, men that made mistakes that I saw had made mistakes. But men who loved the United States of America. Men who loved serving it and wearing the uniform. And in the end gave their lives in service to us so that we could have the freedom to choose what we want to do. Men who gave their lives for freedom and so that a country could exist where a Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints can be and thrive and flourish. May we never forget their sacrifice, nor the sacrifice of so many other brave men and women who have given their lives in the service of this country, in the service of liberty.